Hi, this is Sean Carney, the president of 40 Days for Life. And by the grace of God, this ministry has had the opportunity to help 186 abortion facility workers who have had a change of heart and left their jobs. And it is a tremendous blessing because it points to the reality of the pro-life movement, that it is indeed a movement of converts. And a movement of converts will always be a movement of hope. And that leads us to make a very exciting and big announcement today. And that is that former Planned Parenthood manager Sue Thayer will join the National 40 Days for Life team to help other leaders have a big impact on Planned Parenthood. And she will also help other abortion workers leave their job. Sue is no stranger to 40 Days for Life. In fact, she is the only Planned Parenthood employee who has left and gone on to lead a 40 Days for Life campaign outside of her former workplace. And Sue did that, and her former Planned Parenthood is one of the many that have closed following a 40 Days for Life campaign. Sue will join our team to help leaders and to be that point of contact for other workers. And Sue, here we are in our headquarters, a closed Planned Parenthood abortion facility. And what a joy and a blessing it was to know you through you leading a 40 Days for Life campaign outside your former workplace. And now joining the national team to help our leaders impact the abortion industry.
I just cannot believe that I'm actually here and part of the team now, Sean. You know, for many years, really, people have said, you know, you always talk about 40 Days for Life and how much you love it and all that. Do you work for them? And I'd always laugh and say, I don't work for them, but I'm their biggest fan. And so now here I am.
We had to change that.
Yeah, actually getting to be on the team, part of the team. And it's also just a real blessing to be in this facility, which was a notorious abortion facility, and see the transformation and just the beauty that has come from it, and the wonderful staff here and the 40 Days team. So it really is a miracle.
Well, as you know, as a local leader and somebody who is a big advocate for 40 Days for Life, there would be no 40 Days for Life without local leaders, people raising their hands saying, I want to lead a campaign. And we have said from the beginning, you know, yes, we're there to pray for the babies. Yes, we're there to offer loving alternatives to women and men seeking abortion. But we're also there for the abortion facility workers. And your story, before you started working for 40 Days for Life, it just shows that full transition that God accomplished in you and in so many people who are in this industry.
Truly, you know, if you can come out of the abortion industry and not just survive it, but actually be redeemed and have just a God experience and have your heart be transformed and changed, you know, it's just proof to the fact that we serve a big God. He can forgive anybody and anything. And I'm just so excited to be able to share that with other workers that are coming out and trying to help them, you know, get their feet on the ground and understand that there is life after the abortion industry.
You know, there's so many workers that have left Planned Parenthood. You know, you left, Abby Johnson left, she was the director of this facility, Ramona Trevino. And, you know, there's this exodus out of the abortion industry. You're not going to see this reported in the media, but it is truly happening. You know, you left, And you could have gone on, you have children and just moved on, and thank God that he got you out of this dark part of your life. But you decided to lead a 40 Days for Life campaign, and you're the only former worker to ever do so. Why did you do that?
You know, I really was kind of like 2 years down the road, and I was suffering from the ostrich syndrome. I've shared this before, but I thought, you know, I've done my part, I'm out of there, and I'm just gonna let this go. I wouldn't even drive down the street, you know, where the abortion facility was in Storm Lake. And that really worked well for me for quite a while. But then, you know, God just kept nudging me that you haven't really spoken up enough. And they started doing webcam abortions within 2 weeks after I was gone. And I knew that, and I didn't say anything. And finally, God just really laid it on my heart that if I didn't speak up, I was really going to be part of the problem, continue to be part of the problem. And that's when I finally thought, you know, I need to share it with somebody. And I did. The folks I shared it with were like, well, what can we do? And I said, you know, there's this thing called 40 Days for Life, that's not what Planned Parenthood calls it. It was a lot worse than that.
Doesn't have the positive ring to it that we would like.
Yeah, and I said, let me just look that up, because this was 2011, and I said, let me just kind of look and see. So I looked it up, and it was one of the last days, I think, to sign up for the fall campaign, and without much forethought, I found myself like typing it in, and I hit submit, and then I was like, what have I done? Because I thought, I don't know anything about this, and what am I doing? And this is going to fail miserably. And so, you know, I think that's one of my most exciting prospects of this job, is being able to share that with leaders who are feeling maybe discouraged, or like, I'm in over my head, nobody's signing up, this isn't going to fill up, it's going to flop, you know, those kinds of things, because I am here to be a cheerleader for anybody that needs it.
Well, and you have been for a while, and you're going to be, you've been a tremendous blessing to the pro-life movement, and I know I am excited to have you a part of 40 Days for Life now. It's great for our leaders, it's going to save a lot of babies, and it's a very bad day for Planned Parenthood and the former workers. And the ones who, like you, who have had the courage, and Abby and Ramona, the courage to speak out and not be silent, it's a tremendous, tremendous blessing. And it shows what's at the heart of this, which is mercy.
Mercy.
You know, and that redemption and changing a place of death into life. And so it's a beautiful thing. And I always tell people, if Sue Thayer can lead a campaign, then maybe you're called to lead a campaign. But if Sue Thayer can even participate in 40 Days for Life, then you can too. So as we gear up for the next 40 Days for Life campaign, really discern your role and pray for those who are working in the abortion industry right now. And maybe there was a seed planted in their mind last campaign or a year ago or 10 years ago. Pray that God will bring that seed that was planted to their attention and prick their conscience and get them out of this horrific industry. And so thank you, Sue, for your courage. You will see Sue Thayer a lot. She is going to be traveling a lot, representing 40 Days for Life, giving talks, representing us in the media, and focusing in on those local leaders and getting more workers out of the abortion industry. So praise God for that. Thank Him for you and for you. And you can find out all the details about your local 40 Days for Life campaign. Go to 40daysforlife.com and check out Sue on the podcast. She will be a frequent co-host on the, bring some like politeness and dignity to our podcast. And so you go to 40daysforlife.com/podcast for that. God bless you, and we'll see you next time.